Welcome back to Luke Lawson Plays. Today we continue our Firewatch adventure, and we are en route to Cottonwood Creek, the place that shall not be named. We'll be heading south across Ruby River, and then we're gonna just jaunt west to Cottonwood Creek. In the last episode, we not only uncovered that we are being listened in on, but Delilah has instructed me to head to this location without letting me actually talk about it, so that we could make sure and not be discovered. I don't really know what to expect once we get there. I don't know if she intends on meeting me there. Kind of nervous to see what might happen. I'm really interested to know more about this research site, the Wapiti Station. He seems to think that he's being observed specifically, that they're doing some sort of environment isolation research. The sci-fi junkie in me wants it to be deeper than that, but this game does not have many of those elements. I am completely baffled as to how the missing people tie into that. I assume that they're connected somehow to the research station. But then again, it could have just been a bear. I mean, I do not know what to expect. I know that we are in the middle of the woods. None of it could be tied together in any way, shape, or form. And it could still just be unconnected events that I'm putting too much thought into. I feel like I heard something in the bushes. What is this game doing to me? Alright, I think we're coming up on... Yep, I think this is the place. We've been found out. I don't hear anything. If I get attacked again, I am absolutely going to lose it. A single ski. I don't even know what I'm looking for. What's that? Cashbox. What in the world? I know I heard something that time.
I'm here at Cottonwood Creek.
You see the cash box there?
It must be around here somewhere.
It is. Find it and open it. I changed the code. It's 5678.
Are you kidding me?
I was in a rush.
Well, little did she know I was about to bust into it. Okay, we'll update the map. We Of course, greatest author of our time, the Honorable Richard Sturgeon. Oh, sweet.
I've got it now.
Good. I spent all day getting you that radio. I hiked to a cash box, lied to a ranger, lied to another ranger, and hopefully you are now holding a clean, untapped radio.
Hopefully.
Holy fuck, Henry. We have to get into that site.
Oh, we're going to.
Whatever these people are doing is illegal, right?
What the fuck is going on? People are listening to us?
I don't know.
Yes.
Our radios
absolutely
are tapped.
Are
you fucking serious?
Our radios are definitely tapped. That's why I left you the one you just got.
How is this even possible?
I don't know, Henry.
What do you know? Are there any other lookouts this is happening to? Someone else in on this? Anyone?
This is just happening to us. Everyone else is fine.
Are you sure?
Yes. I've tried to bring it up to Chimney Rock, Elk's Fork, and Beartooth Lookout, and every one of them got confused. Asked me if I'm okay and if I need to be relieved.
It's because they're in on this. I know it.
I would have
punched him in the nose.
None of it makes any sense.
Who is doing this?
I don't know who could be doing this. Henry, I've been at this job off and on for 13 years. Sometimes here, sometimes over near Jackson, a couple times down in Wind River. And nothing like this has ever happened before.
Am I just making all of this up? I mean, the eavesdropping, the spying, is this... Fuck, are you... Is any of this real?
Surely.
What? Are you serious?
Maybe I'm just losing my mind.
What?
Like Julia.
What happened to Julia?
We're not getting into that.
Nothing. It doesn't matter. Just... Maybe there was something in the water, or our... condo was underneath some power lines, and you, Delilah, you're not real.
Henry, you are losing it. I don't know everything that's happened to you, but
is he going
you
crazy?
Have to pull yourself together, okay?
Pull yourself together,
real.
Man.
Okay?
Okay.
Henry, sweetie, I am real, and this is happening. I'm as real as the sky is blue. Take a second.
Just call me sweetie.
Side.
I mean, yeah, I'm fine.
Okay, I'm all right. I'm,
absolutely.
I'm headed towards the site.
Good. Keep your head up.
We've got a ways to go to get back to the site, but I think. Our axe will help us get there a little more quickly.
Not great.
What?
What is it?
I filed a report that said that neither of us ever talked to or saw those girls.
What
the?
That's
a few weeks back.
The worst possible thing you could have done.
What? Why would you do that? I told you to say the minimum and just keep it vague. Transcript of that entire conversation.
Yeah.
And I've filed a report that's a blatant lie.
Oh, and those girls are still missing.
Oh, you have absolutely made a mistake. Cannot believe. So there's a transcript available somewhere, probably at this research facility. I gotta get to the lake. That has her blatantly lying. I just don't understand. Okay. So from the wheel, we can head northeast, and I think we can cut through. And we really only have two available options. I say we go northwest. There should be a trail here that will take us back towards the lake. From the lake, we'll just take the long way around to the station, or at least the gate of the station. Oh my goodness. Okay, so assuming that all of this is in my mind, then I'm going crazy. Assuming that it's not in my mind, and that something truly is happening, then I have the possibility of being implicated in the disappearance and or murder, should the bodies be found, of the two missing girls. Because we know that they've been listening in on our conversations. The fastest route here is going down. Repel, sir. Down you go. I don't know what to think. I kind of had a small psychotic break asking if this was real, if she was real, worried that he's going down the same path as Julia was, or is, I should say. I mean, I feel for him. But it certainly doesn't mean he's going crazy. He's just caught in a crazy place. Nope. Look at your map, sir. I absolutely took a wrong turn. We gotta head north. I think going down the ravine was a terrible idea. Yeah, we've got to go back up. Okay, so once we get to the top, we're just going to continue along that path. Getting me so worked up, I'm losing my direction. At least no one's gone around cutting the ropes. Climb. Come on, man. My heart is racing right now. Glad I can sprint indefinitely. Okay, yep. Definitely took a wrong turn at Albuquerque. We are back at the mouth of Jonesy Lake. I think I can clear some brush. Shortcuts always take longer. Okay, so that's the gate we need. We're gonna cross the stream. Never cross the streams. Never cross the streams. I think I can take this trail here. Not far now. And if I... God, this is where I got jumped. Do I need to go down? Yes. Yes, I must. Yep, I remember the rocks. And we'll give this lock the old 1-2. Just for in case we need a quick escape. Oh, timber. Nope, we're not getting out of here yet. We got things to do. Is that a face? Am I going crazy? I feel like
I'm busting the gate down. There's nobody around, and it's the quickest way in.
Ugh.
Copy that.
Seems legal.
I got stung by a bee.
Okay. Is that it?
Deathly allergic?
Yeah. Did it hurt?
Yes. Kind of.
Yes, it hurt.
Okay, I'm sorry.
Can I keep this? Absolutely. Alright. We're gonna go ahead and end it here. We have made it through the gate into a cordoned off area of Wapiti Station. It is clearly a government site. We do not know what it entails, but we believe that it is a research facility. What is being researched is still unknown. I have recently been stung by a bee. I don't know if that is relevant at this point in time, but it happened, and there's nothing we can do about that. Appreciate you guys sticking around. If you are enjoying this series, please make sure to subscribe so you can get updates when the next episode is available. If you like the video itself, I would appreciate you giving it a like. And if you've got any feedback, I would absolutely appreciate your comments down below. Thanks for sticking around, and we will see you next time. Bye-bye.